It's a tough gig being a pollinator these days, especially in big cities. Land is being used differently, and that's a threat to pollinating insects. But a new study of four UK cities shows that increasing urbanisation doesn't have to be a death sentence. A team of ecologists looked at nine types of land use that make up most of a city's area. If you exclude buildings, roads and water, which aren't much use to pollinators anyway. First, they counted the total number of pollinators and plants in each area, recording how many different species there were as well. The more numerous and varied the plants, the greater the biodiversity of pollinators. No surprises there. Gardens held the most and most varied pollinating insects, but not all garden plants are equally appealing. Hydrangeas, daisies, and forget-me-nots were less appetizing, whereas among pollinators' favourite flowers were dandelions, brambles, and buttercups, ones that gardeners often pull up. Next, the researchers wanted to know how land could be better managed to support pollinator communities. So they built a computer model to test how giving more land to each different land use might make pollinator networks more robust. In other words, more resilient to species loss. They found that the biggest bounce in robustness came when they allotted more space to allotments. Even though, with the boost, allotments still only accounted for less than 1% of city space. Allotments host fruits, vegetables, and weeds as well, a mix which provides a great variety of flowers. The researchers also wondered if there were other ways to boost the robustness of pollinator communities. According to their model, this could be achieved by planting more flowers in parks and allowing wildflowers to grow in verges and other green spaces. A few simple strategies, say the researchers, could help support pollinators in cities across the world. Add more allotments, plant flowers in parks, and don't mow the grass.